Okay, let me read my little intro right quick. So we're living in a world full of people who are committed to some form of soul tie. Soul ties are truly ties that bind. There are good soul ties and there are bad soul ties. Soul ties can be, for example, a mother's love for a child. Another example, soul ties can bring two friends together who share a common experience together. A negative soul tie can be the most common one that we normally see generally in our world today is sex outside of marriage. That's the general, that's the number one. Another form of the demonic soul tie is between churches, pastors, family, and friends. Somebody repeat that after me. Churches.
Churches.
Pastors.
Pastors.
Family.
Family.
And friends.
And friends.
All right. There are two types of soul ties. Somebody say there are two types.
There are two types
of soul ties.
Of soul ties.
Okay. There's what we call a soul tie. T-I-E. Mm-hmm. And then they have soul ties. T-I-E-S. The soul tie is the thing that locks you into a person or an event through trauma, through movies, through an experience. Soul ties is the thing that wraps you up and sits you in a spiritual jail cell. It's the ties. It's the family experience that we see that brings a past problem into your right now that calls you to react. You can use that as an old boyfriend or old girlfriend you see over there in Kroger's. You've been married for 45,000 years, everything is well, every year you and your wife eat well. But all of a sudden, you see Man-Man or Shaquita over there and something leaks inside of you. That's a tie. That's a tie. Do you see? You understand what I'm saying? That's a tie that's bringing you, that's taking you back to a past event that's showing up into your now, and if you're a believer, that's God's indication of saying it's time to deal with that. But if you are not a believer, what it does, it holds you hostage to the past, hijacks your marriage or relationship which you have going on right now. Because the same thing that broke you up is the same thing that will put you back together. Because sometimes bad things can be a little sweet on the surface, but have a deadly consequence. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. All right. So that's a difference. That's a soul tie, and there are soul ties. Mm-hmm. And in our life and in our world, it's the ties that bind. Mm-hmm. It's not the tie, because we had went past the tie. The tie brings you to a certain individual, to a certain place. You may excel in math, but you hate science. So you'll take classes other than science to avoid taking science, because that's the thing that tied you up. Do that make sense? The ties is the thing that supersedes the work. You may master everything, but it supersedes that. You could excel in school, but you never have a good job. You can make all the good grades and have all the potential. I'll give you an example. Have you ever seen people who in high school they was most likely to succeed but they don't crack?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You see them type of people?
Yeah.
Have you ever seen them type of people? You know, they these were the couple. They just look good together. They probably did. They just look good together in high school, maybe in college. But what wound up happening was that when you look at them later, you will see that they really couldn't stand each other. They was together, but they couldn't stand you. They done went on somewhere else. Okay, let me say it like this. I got these looks. Very too early for these looks, y'all. Watch this here. Have you ever linked up with somebody and you knew? They're like, God, dog, you know you like them, but you can't leave them.
Yeah, right.
That's a tie.
Right.
But when you try to leave, the thing strengthened now becomes a soul tie. It's a tie. It's the ties that bind, because you want to leave, but you can't. Okay? If you walk down this street, have you ever been with somebody and you're thriving in your relationship or your marriage or you at this job, but somebody say, well, we got this job, and that was the job that you always wanted, but you at this job. But the job that you want, you in Texas, but it's in Ohio.
Right. Yeah.
And it's open.
Right.
And the man wants you to come tomorrow. You see, it's the ties that's binding you here from prohibiting you from going up there. In other words, the devil would tell you that that job is the only job that's available in Ohio. God cannot open that job down here. So you got to make a decision. Remember, the devil wants you to make a quick decision in a moment's time, so when you won't have to think to put a word to what you're dealing with.
Right.
So when you do that, that's treason in God's eyesight. Because he said, we're supposed to seek him in all things.
Yeah.
Okay? We would explore the differences between the two. God warns us that God is a jealous God. Let's go to Exodus 34. Show you something right quick in Exodus 34. He's a jealous God. So when we make these decisions outside of him, Exodus 34 and 14. Let's go back up to verse 12. It says, take heed to thyself, lest thou make a covenant. Somebody say covenant.
Covenant.
All right. With the inhabitants of the land. Now when he's speaking about these inhabitants of the land, he was talking about these different little cities. The Canaanites, the Avites, the Amorites, the Moabites. You're talking about all these ites. Because these people had messed around and left with the children of Israel, but they left and they formed their own little world out there. And they were serving heathen gods. Okay? And the children of Israel have been infected. So because they didn't take care of that, then what happens when they traveled among them and they went out, because a heathen can't stay in the presence of God. Okay? Stop trying to keep Leroy. Stop trying to keep Tamika. You have the spirit of the living God in you. And you have people praying for you. So you can't go too far. The fact remains is this here. You're either going to come in on by your own volition, or you're going to come in being skull dragged and hurt and kicked and maimed. Because we serve a powerful God. Okay, watch this here.
Hey, you lying.
Okay, watch this here. I felt that somewhere. I do what I want to do. Watch this here. It says, take heed to thyself, lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land. Where did thou go? Lest it be a snare. Somebody say a snare.
A snare.
In the midst of thee. That snare is one of those things that you're trying to get rid of Leroy, but you can't. You're trying to get rid of Sarah, but you can't. You got married. You had a great big old wedding. It's just you. You even moved to the other side of the world to avoid Leroy. But somewhere Leroy is a snare.
Yes.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a snare. Drugs can be a snare. A person that you tie to can be a snare. And it says, in the midst of thee. That's right in the midst of your marriage. That's right in the midst of you thriving in the company. You got all this prestige, but you always depressed.
Yeah.
It's a snare. Okay? Watch this here. Watch this here. It says, but ye shall destroy their altars, break their images, and cut down their grove. Now, why did it say images? Back then, the people had built things, but the devil is a lot smarter. He know we ain't gonna build no wooden man no more. He know that we ain't gonna build no fat man, bald head man. We may go down there and eat his food, but we ain't gonna go down there and put him in our house.
Right, eat food but not food.
We ain't gonna eat no food. They don't tell them what they could be still open to fry rice. Right?
And we're talking about some spicy fried rice.
And they say, you want some wonton? No, I don't want no wonton. They say, hey, look, sample you out there for wonton. Don't they do you like that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, y'all trying to play me. You walking by the mall, they give you they stick a piece of meat on the toothpick. Boom, here, try it.
Right.
I want some Chick-fil-A. And I think I'll take this, yeah.
Yeah.
Working that thing in your, yeah, I'll take that, I eat that here.
Yeah, I ain't eating.
Coke costs $5, and you go right over there ahead and get in there. I take a Coke too. You need beverage, wash that down. And yeah, how much is your Coke? $5.50. $5.50. Well, get in. I take that. Do y'all see what I'm saying? It's an image. And it says, cut down that grove. Watch this here. For thou shalt worship who?
No other
God. For the Lord whose name is what?
Jealous.
Is a what?
Is a jealous God.
Now I didn't say that. Now your eyes was just on that. And you can get up there and say, you know, I can be jealous because God was jealous. I won't Pastor Ray's wife. Because I'm, no, you can't have her. The doggone girl is mine.
Amen.
Mike and Paul had that fight. I don't know who won the girl, but I know they something about it. Watch this here. So when you look at it, when you look and understand how God views it, then you will make better choices. See, our job is just to tell them. Now, what you do with it, that's on you. Because God said his word will return to him what?
Glory.
So therefore, you can run from it and ignore it, it's going to judge you.
Yeah.
Or you can adhere to it and it will what? Bless you.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that something? He said his word came by. Watch this here. So watch the type of God. Now, when you look at these gods, what happens is the devil is real genius. Because what he does, y'all, he knows that the ancestral pool had not subscribed to serving God. Right? So in the process of that, what he does, he says, now, I can't stop what God is doing in their life because grandma, grandpa, even in the midst of all of this craziness, there was somebody praying back here. God always has a solitaire in the family. That person is quiet, that person always get dumped on, that person always in the corner back there, but that person is always back there lifting up the family. How do we know? The Bible says that Job sought God for his grown children.
Yes, Lord.
You see what I'm saying? So what begins to happen is that person is tucked way off in the corner, but the evil part look like it's surpassing all of the stuff that the little lady or little man back there doing in the corner back there. Do you see? Because what's happening is that you have each generation compounding sin.
Right.
And then you have each generation taking on the weight of the iniquities of the father and the forefathers. Do you see what I'm saying? So this stuff is way hidden, which forms a stronghold. Yeah, I kind of liken it to one of them blooming onions, right? You take it in, but you don't see what's on the inside. The strongholds, the masterminds, the demons, the big dogs is sitting in the middle. The outer shell is the one that's protected. Those are the ones that sit inside of your lineage. So when we're doing deliver, we're pulling back the outer layer.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Trying to get to them.
Yeah.
That's in the middle. Those are the sins of the Father. Those are the ones that God is saying, those are the ones that we allow to inhabit the land. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's going to get good. It's going to get good. Watch this here. Watch this here. Thank you, Lord. Okay. When you begin to see it, how God see it in the form of the jealousy part, then your eyes will be illuminated. Okay? Watch this here. The eyes are the windows to the soul. Let's go to Matthew 6:22. The eyes are the windows to the soul. Be careful who you allow your eyes to feast upon. 6:22. It says, the light of the body is the foot.
The eye.
The light of the body is the head.
The eye.
The light of the body is the spine.
The eye.
No, it says right here, the light of the body is the foot.
The eye.
What about the light of the body is the total.
Eye.
Okay. If therefore thine eye be single, then the whole body shall be what?
Full of light.
Watch this here. Let me give an example. When I first met Felicia, I wanted her to look into my eyes. Because I sure wanted to look into her.
Yeah.
Look at your mind. Ain't that what Dracula did back in the day?
Well, he did.
He, that big old mascara up under his eyes, he had that pointed hair, his hair was slicked back, and he raised his cape up, it was all red in the back. He was real pimp, wasn't he? Mm-hmm. And he stood outside the window, and he flapping his wings, and the lady got his leg already turned, biting me. But he wasn't invited. But these women said they said they just knew that incubus was coming in the room. Succubus was coming in the room.
What they do turn and
they said fighting. And they ain't all seductive and things like that. All the men around America said, I want that woman. And Franklin said, I'm gonna get her and you. And I'm gonna bite her neck and I'm gonna come into your house later. See how that thing works?
Right.
All right now. Y'all ought to give me $5 for that. That wasn't part of my notes, right? Pray, look at her. Don't ever say that. You're asking for money because you said. But anyway. Some people said, see, that's why I don't go to that church. They forget everything what you say. They just wind it back to what you said. It's like
the money.
Yeah. Get the light of the eye. He talking about money. And so what winds up happening is that he has to be invited in, but he's looking. Do you see?
Yep.
He's looking. Now, once the eyes begin to mingle, though the two people are looking at two physical beings, they have no clue that they're looking into the soul of a person. Do y'all see this?
Right.
Yeah, I know all of us have our eyes looked into. And some of our eyes, you know what? Guess what? I feel a strange thing coming. That's nobody. Everybody trying to play me now. Watch this here. Have you ever got in trouble and your folks told you, who you looking at like that?
Right.
And then when you looked off this way, they said, oh, you trying to be smart. Look at me. You looking. What you look? You told me, shut up.
Yep.
Right.
So right.
Yeah.
Look at me when I'm talking. You looking. You trying to not have that mean look. You trying to just look happy. You just trying to look because you knew if you keep looking, and as they talk, they're getting closer, and you know? So it's one of those, or one of these things here. RJ can be cutting up, and I can do this. And he'll straighten up.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see?
Uh-huh.
Because the eyes are the windows to the soul.
Right.
It become in a threatening mode. It become in a love mode.
Yeah.
In prison, they say, you mean mugging. Yeah. Not even, I can be talking to the dude behind you, Charles, but the dude in front, what you looking at me like that? I'm talking to the brother. You better really clarify that thing, because you're going to have some problems.
Right.
You're going to have a problem. He thinking that you talking to him, but you're not. Have you ever had this thing? You're like, and dude like me, no, dude behind you. Oh, yeah, okay. That kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Because if you don't make that connection, the eyes can say a whole lot.
See you waiting.
Okay. Watch, something in your heart got me hooked on. Mm-hmm. But you have to look at them first before it goes down to the
heart.
All right, I know I have to throw some word in that one. I just don't believe. You know you got high off Michelle A. When Michelle A was singing Something's in My Heart, you know you just vibe through the song. You just vibe through the song. You took my love, I'm with you. There's no limit to the love. And you just, and all the women just melted in the guys. God said, I ain't really have to say much. Go back and tell all his buddies. I was thinking it was gonna take a month. Take out to eat. Yeah. A lot of these songs are mixed with mixed emotions to have to give you a picture to be able to see. But the enemy goes past that and he's already forming a soul tie.
Yes.
Y'all see what I'm saying? All right, now watch this here. The soul is where the will, mind, and the emotions dwell.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, Mariah Carey said, "You give me emotion." Remember, she was singing that. She said it's deeper. So in other words, she was saying that you already there. I was already there before you got there, but it took you to come and put me there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, y'all trying to play me. Y'all trying to play me like God will save all y'all life. Okay, that song, Mint Condition, Pretty Brown Eyes,
yeah.
You know. You, in other words, when he was singing that, it's just a song. And the ladies just went crazy over the man. And every guy that's sitting there saying, God, when he hit this note right here, I'm just going to, I'm going to run every red light trying to get on. I'm going to hit this one to the dance. Because back then, you had to rewind and say, when she got in the car, the song is automatically come on.
Right.
Right. It just happened just to come on like that.
Oh, you know, God.
There are certain songs that, and movies that will open up your eyes.
Right.
Do y'all see what I'm saying?
Yes.
But it's a strategic plan of the enemy.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see? To set you up in a now in your saved life, so when you walk up out of church and say, hey, Pastor, really pretty, whatever, let me, ooh, turn on the radio and you mess around and hear Southern Girls. And all of a sudden you're down in the South. You're like, and the devil will show you all of these Southern Girls.
Come on.
Come on,
y'all. Y'all see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You said you told the Lord that you want to get married, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. But the Lord is saying there's unresolved soul ties.
Right.
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 Let's deal with them. And the devil heard that. He heard that. So all of a sudden he stirred up. You begin to see all kind of love moving with love making. And but the problem is, they married and you're not.
Right.
Do you see? Uh-huh. And sometimes it don't even matter if they're married.
Right.
Do y'all see what I'm talking about? Okay, watch this here. It's called an old one.
Okay.
It's been around in your lineage for a long time. And the only thing he did was sat in the middle, waiting to be activated. Y'all see what I'm saying? Oh, he's nasty. Watch this here. The soul is where the will, mind, and emotions dwell. That creates thoughts. Let's go to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians 10 and 5. 2 Corinthians 10 and 5. It creates thoughts. All right. Now let's see what the Lord said about these thoughts. Verse 3. Though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through Paul. Susan.
God.
Why I got these feelings then? Why I can't get rid of these feelings then? If it's a strong thought, why can't I get Teresa out of my mind? I ain't never met nobody named Teresa, but it's a good name, you know. It's better than Anastasia. We're going to use Teresa. Anastasia is a hard name to remember. How can I get Tamika out of my mind when I married to this woman for 14 years?
Right.
Is it? But the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the what? Pulling down of what?
Strongholds.
Now watch this here. Now when you begin to really understand what this scripture means, watch this here. That stronghold where those demons are been in your lineage for years, they look up. And they tell lust and perversion, and they tell fear and anxiety, go attack.
Right.
Because they mention the stronghold. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes.
All right. Watch this here. It says, casting down imaginations and every high thing that does what? Exalt itself against the knowledge of God. Do you see that? It's trying to insert its authority over God by telling God, I have a right to stay in this lineage. And they do, because it's called the iniquities or the sins of a father. But because you mention it, right?
Uh-huh.
participates. Okay. Why do you think at most football and basketball games, baseball games, there are less injuries? You have them, but they are so less. Because they are mentioning God's name in the opening prayer. And they close with God's name. Do you see? If it was left up to the enemy, he'll make it where every dude with a bad attitude playing baseball, make sure he's slaying it way up there in the stands and knock somebody out and possibly kill him. Do you see what I'm saying? If it was level to a football, you know a football player would take that helmet off and just go to beat somebody to death with that thing? It can happen. It can happen. Same instance when you mention the enemy's name. Watch this. When a believer that knows his position in Christ, meaning he knows the word, when you mention strongholds to the enemy, he has to stand to attention. Because at the mention of Jesus' name, demons what? To an unbeliever, it's just, oh, that's just him. They're going to respond, but that's just him. Right. We're going to go back down.
Right. Yeah, right.
Nothing quaking there. Mm-hmm. Watch this here. It says, and bringing into captivity, what? Every thought to the obedience of who?
Christ.
Not Pookie.
Right.
You don't share everything with Pookie. You don't share everything with Tamika. You don't. Look, there are some things that my wife can only help me with, though I share a lot of my heart with her. There are some things that maybe she's not ready to handle until God deals with me privately.
Yeah.
Okay, me and Charles were talking about this earlier. Sometimes people don't know what they're dealing with. They can't explain what they're, what's wrong with that? I don't know. Why can't I, you know, ask a man why he cheat? They don't know. I don't know. I was slick. Why you do that? That devil will have them all confused. Because he do not want them to know that your daddy, your grandma, your granddaddy had problems. Because if you discover that, maybe you will make some choices.
Yeah.
Come on,
Doug.
Hallelujah. Yeah, come on, Doug.
I just thought I was a bad dude. Yeah. I didn't know I was adding to my bondage. So when I decided to get delivered, I got Tamika, Carol, and Carol been with Samantha. Samantha get there. All of a sudden, you get these weird things. You got homosexual tendencies. You're like, no, I don't. Well, she been with this person. Because who they slept with, you slept with.
Uh-huh.
Tied, bind, right?
Oh, God.
Right. Okay. The Bible says, how could two walk together except they what?
Agree.
So when you ask somebody else is going this way, somebody else is going that way, and the third person comes in, it forms a knot.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Nice. Have you ever tried to get a knot out of your shoe? Have you had to take your shoe and take your teeth and come off? Shoe stinking all of this. Leave my foot in there. Got to wash your own mouth. But that's the strength of that knot. I can't believe you know. Watch this here. The eyes are the windows to the soul. The soul is the will, mind, and emotion. Where the emotions dwell, that creates thoughts. The thoughts create images. And the images reveals the heart. Let's go to Matthew 15:18. You got to see this stuff. See, the reason why I'm helping you to see these scriptures, because y'all can say, he made that up. And I don't want to get in the flesh saying, no, your mama made that up. So, no, I didn't make that up. You see what I'm saying? Because it's all in the flesh. God, you pray for me, I pray for you. Okay. You may say, what kind of church is that, John?
I know you.
What kind of church? Hey, watch this here. Now, everybody had this battle here before. You know, you see this man? How you doing? Bless the Lord. Walk out of this place, oh boy. See him in Kroger's and forget what, you made me forget what I was in there. Man, you just left church. I don't care. You the pastor, but I still dust you off.
Matthew, what?
We 15:18. We're still flesh.
Amen.
Thank God that God still remember us that we are just dust.
Yes.
Right.
Sinners saved by by grace.
Amen.
He didn't put it in the Bible how could blessings and curses come out of the same well for nothing.
Amen.
He knew that at some point if you get up in the middle of the night, get to one, you hit your big toe on the end of that post.
Right.
Do you see? But after a while, there should be some maturity.
Right.
And these things shouldn't be perceived out of your mind. Now, you got a custom demon. We going to take care of that right now. All right, now, we cast that devil out right now. That devil come out you right now. Matthew 15:18. Watch this here. Verse 17. Do you not understand that whatsoever enters into the mouth goeth into the belly, and it is cast out to draw? But those things which proceed out of the mouth comes from the what?
The heart.
And it does what?
Defile the man.
Okay. Now let's see what some of these strongholds he says. See, you may think it's Larry and it's Susan and it's Carol. Oh no. No, it's not them. Let's see who the real. Watch this here. For out of the heart proceeds evil thoughts. That's the soul tie. Stronghold. Murder. That's the stronghold. Adultery. Fornication. Theft. False witness. Blasphemy. These are the things that what?
Defile the man.
I didn't say it. Do you see? So when somebody, if I have a connection, this is an example. If I have a connection to an old flame, right? A flame is a flame. A flame. It comes back. Mm. That's why we call them old flames. A flame is something you thump in the wind and the wind carries. And then it waits for the right opportune time when your defense is down or when things are going great and it shows back up.
Right.
Boom.
Right. Yeah.
Did that make sense? So let's just say, for instance, me and Felicia, we married, we thriving, we going, we just celebrating our anniversary.
Yeah, we did.
And so I'm sitting there still basking in the moment that this woman had enough sense to put up with a guy like me. Right. And I just get in my feelings, you know. Men are not supposed to get in their feelings, but this is the term that they use now. Right. So they just saying that men get in their feelings, because
men don't get in their feelings. Yes. I never read what David got in his feelings.
David would take you out. You tell David you soft. David would like, say what? Say it again. Abner said, I get him. Do you see what I'm saying? Uh-huh. See, this world has sissified men. Yeah. I got it on tape. Sissified. That was still a bona fide word back then. Pillabites. Pillabites. The thing is that when you see a strong man, the world try to break him down by saying that he's not a sensitive man.
Uh-huh.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Right.
In other words, it keeps him from hearing God, because we know that God is a man of war. He's a man of war. Meaning that he looks for demons to go to war for. Yeah. But he's not going to do it. He's going to use you to do it.
Yeah.
Right. So how can I go do it when I got some evil thoughts in my mind?
Right.
When I got some adulteries in my mind, when I got some fornication.
Come on,
how is that? Those devils say, I confront another devil that has a lying spirit, and the devil saying, I can't come out. And I'm saying, why? Because you're a liar.
Right.
We're on the same team. Now all of a sudden, I mean, my feelings, Felicia, you're gonna have to cast this one. I'm just not prepared for that.
Right.
This devil gonna tell me. We were riding all the way home. This devil gonna tell me that I got a lying spirit. And the Lord impress upon her, you do. Now I'm mad with her.
Right, come on.
Because see, this thing refuses to come out out of the lineage.
Yeah,
right.
Yes.
Y'all see how that worked?
Yeah, yeah.
So the strongholds and the soul ties are these evil spirits that inhabits the body of people and things that creates a real life event in our life that draws us to, because we still infected. Oh yeah. You know, watch this here. It says, your emotions create the thoughts, your thoughts create the images reveal the heart, and what's in your heart, what's in your heart will come out of your mouth. Luke 6 and 45. So what's in your heart is going to come out of your mouth. Not Luke 6:45. Not Luke 6:45. Proverbs 13 and 3. I'm sorry. You make your mind up. Make your mind up.
Proverbs 13 and 3.
And when you allow God to examine your heart, because when you begin to do stuff for yourself, you know, the Bible says faith comes by hearing. And hearing by what?
Word of God.
So you just don't read it. You allow the Word of God to read it back to you. And then the Word of God will go into the places to where that Word needs to go. Watch this here. Verse 2. It says, a man shall eat good by the fruit of his what?
Wow.
But the soul of the transgressor shall eat what?
Violence.
Mm-hmm. He that keepeth his mouth keepeth his what?
His life.
But he that open wide his lips shall what?
Have destruction.
Do y'all see that?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So oftentimes, wow, women shed a heart.
Mm-hmm.
It's either going to bring a blessing or a curse. Mm-hmm. Oftentimes they shed a heart with damaged men. And those damaged men play on those words to get to where they want to be. And what they're doing, they're adding more deposit in you. The Bible says that I'm gonna say this part while I'm thinking about this. When you sleep with somebody, you become one flesh, right? When a man goes into a woman and he puts deposits semen into her, right?
Right.
This is how they become one flesh. When she goes to clean herself, the enemy makes sure that she don't get all of the semen.
Right.
So the rest of the semen goes to the bone. When it goes to the bone, it takes the Lord to go into the Word of God to go into to separate bone and matter. Because all of these men that's going into the bone help build the bone.
Right.
And we thought it was calcium.
Come on.
Right.
It's men.
Wow.
That's why he said, bone of thy bone, flesh of thy flesh. That means that though this person is long gone, you're still connected. That's why you got to get Tyrone probably out of his eyeball. And us men too, because some women can drive men crazy. Now in the street we have a word for that, because we're a holy place, we ain't going to talk about all that there.
Right,
but
right.
We would say that there is a connection that's in the spirit realm,
right,
that takes place that make that man nose wide open. You know why it's wide open? Because it's breathing in all of the past experience of what he has been with, dealing with her.
Right.
I'm searching my stuff now because I got to walk down my own tree. It says, watch this here. It says, whatever the issues are in your life, it will soon surface. The mouth speaks, then confirms, forms your world. Your mouth speaks, and it forms your world.
Yes.
Psalms 45 and 1. I don't know about all that. I hear what you're saying. This sounds all good, but you know, hey man, I'm done with Eric. I'm done with Karen. Okay, let's see. Psalms 45 and 1. Your words form your world. Watch this here. My heart is indicting a good matter. I speak of the things which I have made touching the king. My tongue is the pen of a what? Alright. Bring that around to where I'm at. I love you, Carol, and I'm in high school. Me and Carol break up. I love you, Susan. I just want to get somewhere. But I'm telling her what she wants to hear.
Right.
And I'm in college.
Right.
Let's just say, man, I'm out of college. I tell about four or five other women. Girl, you know I love you. You're trying to get to me. You're trying to get somewhere with me. You know what I'm saying? Oh, girl, come on now. You know how you come on now. Hey, hey, come on. And then us women, we have a way of flipping. Hey, it's your fault. You know, we do that stuff. Right.
Well, maybe I do need that. Right.
And you just caught me. Mm. Isn't that something?
Amazing.
Now, he's thinking that he's all that. But he don't know he's being manipulated too, because his pappy probably did the same thing.
Right.
And his mama would probably,
That's okay, you good.
His mama was probably that weak, huh?
Right.
Do y'all see what I'm saying? See how the devil working on both fronts?
Well, come on.
Working on the weaknesses.
Yeah.
One thing he doing is in the other one, you know. And so, now, I decided I married my bad mama Jam over here.
Right.
Right, because she is a bad mama Jam. Mm-hmm. And so, just as fine. I think I'll walk around this pool, people. Sometimes the lightning roars, y'all. But anyway, and so, what was I saying? And so, I marry her,
right?
Now, I brought God down in the midst of this.
Right.
And God said, I really had to sanction this. Mm-hmm. But because they read in my word, and I have seen the joy that was already set, I seen them in this present time, far more than what they can think of, even though they speak right now. I see them way down in the kingdom. But they don't know, because they disobeyed my word, they're going to have a real hard time, because the enemy has hidden these things.
Yeah.
And their heart is not receptive. So they're thinking just because they're getting it right with me that they're legal, but they got illegal businesses that they need to tend to.
Come on.
That's good. That's good.
You got the five-layer cake, you got all the armor bears, you got all the girls. The pastor is even deceived. Because he got some stuff that's in him. That when he stood in front of the altar, he didn't get some things right.
Yeah. Come on, God.
Yeah.
See how this thing work?
Uh-huh.
Okay. And the devil is sitting right there. He said, I got this one. He got the whole thing sold up. Uh-huh. And now the one that's probably in there that's totally free from that kind of mess, he makes sure they got to leave early or they can't hang around. In other words, a real bona fide believer can't hang around. The spirit just won't agree with the nonsense.
That's just the one on in the room. Come on, God. Right.
That's good.
Amen.
You've been in those situations.
Uh-huh.
You can't go to an abortionist place and sit down. I'm just going to say, it's just waiting right. The Lord is saying, I knew you within your mind. You know, I just can't hang around here.
Right.
You just have to get out of the place. Do you see what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
It's just some things in the world that God has put in you, it just don't fit.
Right.
Okay? Just don't fit. And I decided to marry, and all of a sudden, things are going real good until life issues surface. What is the number one issue? Money. But is money the real issue?
No.
No.
Okay, what if I stay gone too long? First thing she's gonna be thinking, you was with another woman. You was with another man. Well, why are you thinking that? Why are you thinking that? I thought you said you was done with Steve.
Right.
Well, what took you so long? I just forgot I needed some socks. And I was halfway at the house. I started to turn around, but why you didn't call? See, in other words, the enemy is waking up something.
Yeah. Right.
Do y'all see how this thing works?
Yeah.
He's waking up something in the marriage. And then now I storm out, man. God, dog, man. And then all of a sudden these words come out. Man, I should have never married you in the first place. If I knew you were going to be tripping like that.
Right.
Now you just gave the devil, that devil wake up, and that devil that busts up your mama's marriage, your grandma's marriage, everybody's marriage. He wakes up and say, they just destroyed their marriage by the words that they spoke, because their mouth is as the pen of a ready writer. So therefore, make sure the devil of separation, go and start to separate that marriage. I don't care how many spiritual warfare conferences they go to, make sure you hide John Elkhart, Pastor Jim Landry, make sure you hide all of those people. And then if they do happen to find them, make sure it's spirit of confusion. If it's spirit of confusion, go with separation. And make sure that when they hear it, they don't receive it.
Come on.
Only church will fight against each other.
Right.
Demons don't fight against each other. They work with each other. They hate each other. How do I work with you, jealousy? Well, I don't like work with you, alliance.
But they work together.
Right.
Right.
All right.
Your mouth sets the stage. No demon can truly work unless your mouth is being activated. Do you see? The word says, watch this here. Now this, I know my time, but watch this here. I mean, it's gonna get real. I got to watch this here. When the mouth speaks and forms your world, we found it in Psalm 45:1. This is where it gets real dangerous. Watch how this thing sets up. This is real diabolically evil. Now, not being aware of the cunning works of the devil, it forms a stronghold. Because now my mom's saying, she ain't gonna tell me what to do.
Right.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Right.
I think I heard that somewhere before my daddy said that. I think I heard my mama say that too. Who even, he ain't gonna tell me? And I hear my aunt saying, girl, you better not let your man hear that. Did you say that? You know how you hear that. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
See, I always talk tough when Felicia not around. I do. She gonna do what I say. When I say, hey, baby, if you been up, fix it yourself. She did it to me last night. Fix it yourself. I bring me something for her. She don't ever give me a chance to bring her nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But why don't you fix my plate? You got it in your head. You see what I'm saying? That's why I call it all every woman. Watch this here. Watch this here. This is gonna get real crazy. Strongholds automatically places the Christian into bondage. The Christian can go sit in the choir, write Christian books, and is not aware that they are being seduced by doctrines of devils. They cross the line with God by worshiping other gods instead of the true and living God. And that note, let's go to Exodus 20. The devil's main job is to get the believer to sin against God. He already has the unbeliever. He's going to keep the gospel from them. Let's see what he does to us. Exodus 20:5. It says, thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a what? Jealous God. Visiting the iniquities of the father upon the children until the third and fourth generation of them. Somebody say them.
Them.
That hate me. Now that word them, You know why that word, he put that word them there? Because them, he's talking to that underworld that's residing in them. Because if he unveiled their eyes, they can extract or pull themselves from them. Do y'all see this? A person don't divorce because they love each other. They divorce because a spirit came against their house.
Right.
But if the other person who wants a divorce can see what's going on, if they can see them is the one that's manipulating, then they don't qualify to this scripture, because God was talking about the underworld that was using the people to have them to curse God, to make God curse them.
Yeah.
The devil has the unbeliever. He makes the believer sin against God. Okay, remember Balaam. Balaam wanted Balaam to curse the children of Israel. God was listening. And don't know God. How are you going to hang around people that walk out and tell you that you're silly and stupid because they don't understand where you come? You trying to make them, you trying to feed them girl with baby food and they're 21 years old. Don't you know that? Girl with baby food to a grown man is nasty. Who want these strange peas? You see what I'm saying? You cannot. That's one of the things that I have. That's one of the things that God has given me peace about. I can sit at my job and I can sit in that office. I can sit in it and be at peace with myself knowing that I ain't got to get up and just tell somebody about my God. Because they don't want to hear that.
Come on.
I ain't connecting. I ain't trying to form no soul tie with nobody that don't share my faith-based views.
Amen.
It's carnal to them. It's stupid to them. Do you see what I'm saying?
Right.
And I become a religious nut to them.
Right.
Yeah. I don't have nothing for them other than prayer of salvation.
That's it.
I work real close. Real close. And it'd be right there on, and I just go on by my, because you know why? The Bible says, okay, some of y'all think I'm American. Watch this. The Bible says you shouldn't cast your pearls to what?
Swine.
How are you going to cast this precious word that saved your soul, that pulled you out of a pit to somebody that look at your Bible and burn it? You're going to create a soul tie with that person, and you'll be receiving worldly advice from a devil. Mm-hmm. And the Bible says that is sensuous according to James. That is devilish and it's sensuous. And that devil would tell you everything that you want to hear. And when the truth comes, you'll question it. That's treason. You done put another God before God. Now here come the big boys. Here come that sickness. Here come that disease. Here come that ailing plague that always formed. It was always there. It just needed permission to go through the bloodline. Because guess what? When you come into a church like this here, we bind those sicknesses. We bind those diseases. We bind all those infirmities by the confessions that's coming out of our mouth. Because we're trying to form a world with our words.
Come on, God.
And when you violate that word with somebody that's ungodly, that they don't understand that behind the eye problem is fear and anxiety and stress and worry. That's the root cause. But they don't understand it, so they curse that. They say, you pregnant, and you don't know what you're talking about, and you this and that. You better put the brakes on and back up out of that thing and get there and repent and tell God, I'm sorry for casting my pearl to swine. Because sometimes people just need for you to pray for them. God wants you to see the condition and just pray for them.
Come on.
Don't put your mouth on. Just pray for them. I get a lot of people. That ask me questions now. I just look at it. I know what I want to say. And I can hear that. No.
You're right.
No. Tell them this. Tell them this. Had a dude that I went into ODR as a modern day as a cafeteria. Dude asked me a question. It's amazing how people they know who you are, but they don't know you. They see you, they speak to you, and you speak back, but they don't know you. At least you think they don't know you. This dude just said, hey man, what do you think about the he said, I get so sick of these Muslims and these Hebrew Israelites around here. We are the original. I said, man, the only thing that I know is my Jesus know is saved and unsaved.
Right.
Yeah, but what I'm talking about is no. The only thing that my Jesus know is saved and unsaved. You're not a Hebrew Israelite. You're not. You a Gentile. You a sinner saved by grace. If you want the point of reference, all you got to do is go to Acts, where the children of Israel didn't want God, but God saw that the Gentiles wanted it. So to make the Israelites jealous to bring them back, he saved the Gentile. But he told the Gentile, don't get too cocky because this is really for them. I just pulled you in because of grace and mercy.
Yeah.
Dude told me, I get sick of you when you say you ain't gonna get this nowhere else. I said, tell me anybody else who can. Because it, the Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. So if we all in the same boat, on the same team together, and if we're, and if this person is saying the same thing, and that person is saying the same thing, and I come along and say, then we shall be. See, in other words, people are still, whether you realize or not, they try to connect you to a soul tie. They want you to agree with them. And when you don't agree with them, boy, watch out.
Come on.
Mark 7:21. Mark 7, I may have to finish this up next week. Mark 7:21. I just wanted to give us a something to look at. Mark 7:21. Well, you know what? Before we go to 7:21, let's say it, Mark 7. Let's go to verse 15 first. This is worthwhile reading. Watch this here. It says, there is nothing from without a man that entereth into him can defile him. But the things which come out of him, those are the things that do what?
Defile him.
Do you hear that? So the thing is, in other words, you're reading it, but do you hear it? Because, watch this here, when you just read it, do you not know there are many people who read this and fell asleep? Oh, that's good reading. Yeah, well, I agree. But when you read it with the eyes of the Holy Spirit illuminating a particular area in your life, now you're reading it, but you're seeing it. You're seeing the dark places of where God is trying to get to you at. Okay, verse 16. If any man have ears to hear, do you see? In other words, the ears is in the seeing. Because he said, let every man be a liar, and God is all what? True. So if that's the case, how in the world our ears are going to be able to see unless you put your eyes to it? Your ears will hear. Your ears will go back into a dark place. Because you heard him. You heard them calling. Okay. R. Kelly wrote a song called My Body's Calling For You. That was an old familiar song. Because my daddy's daddy, heard those type calls. Because Papa was a rolling stone. Oh yeah. Watch this here. And when he was entered into the house from the people, his disciple asked him concerning this parable, the parable. And he said unto them, are you without understanding? See how the devil intervenes? The devil do not want you to see this. Because if you see it, you may have understanding on how to deal with it. You may not hate your spouse as much as you say you love them. You may not hate your children because they acted just like you.
Right.
You may not hate your friend. It's a devil that came against your house.
Yes.
Wow. I'm getting some deliverance right now. It says, do you not perceive that whatsoever thing from without entered into the man, it cannot defile him? Because it entered not into his heart, but into the belly, and goeth out into drop, purging all meat. And he said, that which come out of the man, that defile the man. For from within, out of the heart, proceeds evil thoughts, adultery, fornication, murder, theft, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lasciviousness, and an evil eye. Blasphemy, pride, foolishness. All these things come from where? Within. So that suggests to me, because it's written in red, that means that Jesus said, that means that there's not a man, woman, boy, or a girl on the planet that don't need deliverance.
Sure. Amen. Right.
Amen.
Do you see? We're talking about soul ties. Soul ties. When Jesus said that people divorced because of a hard heart. Well, what's in that hard heart? What made that hard heart hard? You right. See it right here.
Yes.
Because the person is pretty cool. It's just the thing that the person allowed to come in and make him hard.
That's it.
It makes you look at people a whole lot different. It makes you look at people how through the eyes of how Jesus saw. He said the people, he had compassion upon the people because the people was a sheep without a shepherd. You may have to be the shepherd to the sheep.
Mm-hmm.
If you can look past your own stuff.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Okay, last one, then we'll quit. We'll quit. It's my time. Jeremiah 17:9. It's my time, and Luke is going to be, you know. We got her to let you out. Yeah. Jeremiah 17:9. Watch this here. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. It just can't wait to do evil. Mm-hmm. Why are you laying down? That devil said, won't you go to Valero and just steal that gas?
Mm.
won't you give a piece of your mind? You can't even hardly lay down without you. The phone just burned. And you just got to tell it. I've been having this on my mind for a long, and how long? 3 months. Okay. Get somewhere. Everybody say this. Get somewhere. Sit down.
Shut up.
You ain't got nothing to say. Should have been said. Get on. Watch this off. Watch this. Because while you thinking this and you holding on to this, that devil done formed a stronghold. That mess been in you for a long time. You just a hell of me like that. And you need to come on down here and let us cast at least that. Holding on. All of this, know this is a spirit. But if he out there, we're going to cast him out. We're going to give him a name today. We're going to cast out that holding on to all stuff.
Come on.
This whole I've been woke to tell you, get somewhere and sit down. I'm sitting here enjoying my family, and no wonder I can't even get my swerve on with my wife, because you in here locking me up and just been talking about me over here. I gotta keep the leverage through you. You ain't answering right. You stand out on my phone. Well, I don't know what's going on. The Lord has said somebody talking about you. Somebody probably running you in the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Get somewhere. You know, I told Felita, I bought me some t-shirts, and I was going to put, I got to find the scripture. I know it got to be in there somewhere. I'm going to put on the front of it, get somewhere. And somebody's going to get somewhere, and I'm going to turn around and sit down. Because you ain't got nothing to say. Watch this here. The reason why, I'm going to show you something, and I promise you close. Lucas is still open, y'all. Watch this here. Watch this here. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who could know? Somebody say I. That's right. The Lord searches the what?
The heart.
I try the reins. Even give every man according to his what?
His ways.
Whoa. According to his ways.
Mm-hmm.
According to his ways.
Uh-huh.
If the thing is not dealt with, then he gives that spirit within you his way in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Right.
Wow.
That's good. Do you see? We just run past the scripture and God is saying, this is the thing that I always say. Where are you getting your teaching? Every time that somebody come to me with something crazy, for no disrespect to the pastors, because they can only go on what they know. But one of the things I always say, where did you get that and who or where did you get that teaching? Because that's not what the Bible says.
Yeah.
Watch this here. I tried to reign even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit.
Uh-huh.
See, the ways is going to produce fruit.
Uh-huh.
So if I don't get Tamika, Tammy, Carol, and all these people out of my system, it's going to produce fruit. Oh, it gets even more crazy than that. Watch this here. Not only would it go down and start messing with my marriage, start messing with my children, Watch this here. It produces kidney failure. Yep. This is where most kidney failures form. Because, watch this here. What's in you flushes out through the kidneys,
yeah,
but it can't go because it's clogged. Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. Okay, watch this here. Watch this here. When it gives you, I know Corey Wright, she got our problems. And God can do that right there.
Yes.
Got all these machines and all the, and I'm sitting, I just walk past, but because the heart is not receptive, so all that I can do is just pray.
Right?
Right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, what's behind that? See, God gives you insight in what's behind that. Do you see? It's the iniquities, it's the transgressions of the Father that she can't see the Father. The enemy is making sure that she cannot see. The eyes are the windows to the soul, into the will, the mind, and the emotions that's connected to the heart. So you can talk God's goodness, I agree. You can talk God's a Savior, I agree. But when you say God is a healer, I don't agree with that. That devil says, I'm going to put the stoppers right there, I'm going to strain her eyesight, and I'm going to put in a real life event to carry out my devilish mission.
Thank you, Jesus.
Burns up all your time off. Burns up everything. And then it puts you in a state to where you blame the system for being the system. Causes kidney failure. Watch this here. It says, as the partridge setteth on eggs and hatch them not, so he that getteth riches and not by the right way, that's not by right, shall lead them in the midst of his days, and his day's end shall be a fool. They die foolishly, not knowing that today God is still a healer.
Yes, yes. Thank you, God.
How many people do you know that's suffering and refuse to acknowledge that God is still a healer? There's a devil somewhere. And they get sitting and upset with you. They spit at the mouth. But son of the football, Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes.
Oh yeah. And strange things will occur. I'm going to pick this up next week. Strange things would occur. You start seeing things. You start visualizing. Your thoughts become real impure because you're receiving the rewards. The Lord said, I'm going to give you the rewards of your doings. You're going to produce after that. Insomnia kicks in. Horrible. You can just sit there. You never like it, but you can sit there and watch this one. You know, it opens the door to more devilish things in our life, and inevitably what it does, it creates and forms a soul tie. And when a soul tie is there, trust me, the only person who can get rid of that is the Lord Jesus Christ.